In this lesson, we're going to learn the various ways of selecting objects and the differences between them. In the open document, we can see a simple floor plan. When we wish to select objects individually, all we have to do is move the cursor onto the object we want to select, and when it is highlighted, to click on it. For instance, I will select a chair from the left room of the floor plan. We can keep selecting more objects just like that, by clicking on them once they are highlighted. So I will select the rest of three chairs around the table one by one, and then I will also select the table itself. Notice that every time the cursor is on an unselected object, apart from the fact that the object is highlighted, a little plus icon appears next to the cursor. This symbol indicates that there's already at least one object selected and another one is going to be added to the selection. Now, imagine that I selected the table by mistake, and I wish to deselect it. I will hold the Shift key from my keyboard pressed, and I will move the cursor on the table I previously selected. When the cursor is on the table, a little minus symbol appears, which indicates that by clicking on the object, it will be removed from the selection. I will click on it, and indeed, it's deselected immediately. Naturally, there is no need to keep pressing the Shift key afterwards. Once I no longer need anything to be selected, all I have to do is press the Escape key from my keyboard. All the objects I previously selected are now deselected automatically at once. Up to now, the procedure of selecting objects individually is as simple as clicking on them. However, what happens when we wish to select the objects that are included in a certain area all at once? There are two different methods for quickly selecting everything that is included in a certain area. Those are called window and crossing. In both methods, we create a rectangle as large as needed to include the objects we want to select. Imagine that I want to select the table along with the little succulent that decorates it. Starting with window, I will click in an empty space in the upper left corner near the table, and then I will move the cursor down to the right. As you can see, a blue rectangle is being created, and it's becoming larger the further I move the cursor. As soon as all the items I want to select are enclosed in this rectangle, I will click again. Notice that the objects are now selected. In case I wanted to select the chairs along with the table using window, I should create a larger rectangle to enclose those two. At this point, let's see how crossing works. I will select the table along with the chairs of the right room, but this time I will start by clicking in an empty space in the lower right corner near the table, and then I will move the cursor up to the left. Notice that a green rectangle is being created, and all the objects that are enclosed in the rectangle, as well as any object that is crossed by it, is being selected. This means that I don't have to fully enclose all the objects I want to select in this rectangle. I just need to make sure that they are either enclosed in the rectangle or at least crossed by its perimeter. Once all I need is selected, I will click again in the upper left corner near the table. Even though the rectangle I created wasn't large enough to enclose both the table and the chairs, they were still selected. So the difference between the two methods is that by using window, only the objects that are completely enclosed in the rectangle are selected, while by using crossing, we select both the objects that are enclosed and the objects that are crossed by the rectangle. Lastly, I would like to mention that from the AutoCAD 2015 version onwards, the selection method lasso was added. To use lasso in either window or crossing mode, I need to keep the click pressed while I draw a freeform area of selection. I will press Escape to deselect everything. Next, I will click near the table and, holding the click pressed, I will draw an area around the center of the left room. To use crossing lasso, I move the cursor clockwise to draw the selection area. Notice that the selection area is green and every object that is being enclosed in this area or crossed by its perimeter is selected. Now, if I want to use window lasso, I could either have moved the cursor counterclockwise from the start or press spacebar from the keyboard to change it automatically without drawing the selection area again. So I will press the spacebar and notice that now the selection area becomes blue and once again only what is fully enclosed in this area is selected. I will press spacebar one more time while I'm holding the click pressed, and notice that a dashed line appears, showing the path that my cursor curved while drawing the area. This is fence lasso mode, and it selects only the objects that are crossed by the path I curve while dragging the cursor around the drawing area. I will release the click and press escape once more to deselect everything again. Personally, I suggest that beginners avoid using lasso mode until they become familiar with simple window and crossing selection methods.